Hello, my name is Gertrudy Boerse and I am the author of this book, Move Forward with Dyslexia. I want to tell you about the brains of people with dyslexia. Most people know that dyslexics are picture thinkers, but we know there is more to that. We think that dyslexics are right-brained people. And that follows a simple principle in our body. Everything, you have two of it in your body, one of them is dominant. So you have two legs. When you play soccer and you're an amateur, you know there is one leg with which you hit the ball. You have two arms. One of them is dominant. You have two eyes. A simple test, we don't do it now, but one of them is dominant. You have two ears. On what ear do you have your phone when you don't have headphones in or on your head? So it's very logical that also one of the two hemispheres in our head is dominant. And I will show this to you in a few slides. The right hemisphere is visual. It's about imagination. It's about seeing the big picture, having a vision. It's our intuitive and empathetic side. It's doing several tasks simultaneously. This side is timeless. It's about seeing connections and relationships. It's thinking from big to small, seeing the bigger picture. It's having new ideas, and it's our innovative side. It's our creative side, not especially artistically, but also being creative with numbers and with words, and etc. We call this way of thinking conceptual thinking. Then there is the left hemisphere that is language oriented. It's thinking step by step. It's about building forms. It's thinking from beginning to the end. It's about applying order. This side is very time consciousness. This side is also very analytical and very logical. It's about thinking from small to big, focused on details, opposite than the left right hemisphere. It's precise and very, very organized. And this side is oriented on numbers and it's mathematical. We call this way linear thinking. And this way of thinking is dominant in our society because most people are linear thinkers. And it's also this way of thinking, but also this way of organizing and this way of performing that is dominant in our society, in our organizations, and in our school system. So the main feature in how each way of thinking processes information is that conceptual thinkers think in images, and when you ask them to write something down or to say something, then the language comes into their minds. Linear thinkers, on the other hand, think primarily in language, and only when you ask them to visualize something, then the images come into their minds. So you could say that each thinker has a front door on one side of the brain. That is our dominant hemisphere. Of course, there is much more to tell about the subject, but this is it for now. So if you want to learn more about this subject, please read our book. You can buy it on Amazon, or you can visit our website, moveforwardwithdyslexia.com. Thank you for watching, and hopefully I will see you next time. Bye bye.